So good morning, everybody. I think we should start. This was the topic suggested by one of you, okay, and therefore I'm going to talk on this. For me, actually, more you go and more you learn, this is a continuous, actually this is a CME, continued medical education for this topic. This is, there are two topics in our field. One is this and the other one is preeclampsia. The more you go in deeper, deeper and deeper planes, you are going to get more and more and more information. But some of the basic things are still the same, what we know from our anatomy books and physiological books. So this is abnormal uterine bleeding. Anybody knows about it? I want to have a small thing, interactive session, so it will be better. So this is the definition. Any kind of bleeding that comes from the uterine cavity. So this was the definition that was challenged. Any kind of bleeding that comes from uterus. Uterus for us is the organ of two. One is uterus and cervix. So sometimes any bleeding from the cervix also is included, because when it is pervaginal bleeding, you never know from where it is coming. But the things which are excluded are any bleeding from the vagina is excluded. Any bleeding which has been there with vulvitis is excluded. Any trauma in the vagina is excluded. Anything related above, that is cervix and above, is introduced in this. So this is the abnormal bleeding from uterine cavity and uterus. So what is the presentation now? How is the patient presented to you? These are the general terms. The commonest is menorrhagia. The opposite to it is hypomenorrhea. Polymenorrhea. Opposite to this is oligomenorrhea, metrorrhagia, and combinations. So menorrhagia is what? Average menstrual loss is said to be to the tune of around 50 to 80 ml. So if it is 50 to 80 ml, then what is to be called as heavy menses? In simple, menorrhagia is heavy menses. Opposite to this is hypomenorrhea, it's scanty menses. There is always a misnomer. We always call it as oligomenorrhea, but that is a misnomer. Oligomenorrhea is something different. Hypomenorrhea is scanty menses. So here I have clarified that whichever is less than 30 ml, it's hypomenorrhea, and whichever is more than 80 ml is menorrhagia. But how can we calculate this? Any idea? Any idea? How do we calculate this? How is the loss calculated? Yes? Soaking of pads, it is one. Then passage of clots, it is second. Okay. Why the menstrual blood doesn't clot? Menstrual blood is flow. It's actually not a blood, but it's endometrial shedding. But why does it not clot? Any idea? Which enzyme? You're right. Is there clotting inhibition or something else? Menstrual blood does clot in the uterus, but there is fibrinolytic activity. So whatever clot is been there is been lysed by fibrinolytic enzymes, and whatever flows out is without any clots. The clots which are very tiny are to be excluded, are to be neglected. But when this fibrinolytic enzyme is consumed, then whatever blood is there cannot be lysed. Therefore clot is there and it comes out. So whenever there is average amount of clot, or a size of a clot, then it is menorrhagia. He said is correct is pads. Okay. मी तो पॅडमॅन पाहिला नाहीये, कोणी काय पाहिलाय का, बट आय हॅव्हंट सीन दॅट. पण त्याच्यात कुठल्या साईजचं पॅड वापरायला अक्षय कुमारने सांगितलं हेही मला माहित नाहीये. बट दॅट डिपेंड्स हेवीली ऑन द विच साईज ऑफ पॅड विच इज बीन यूज. बेटर वुड हॅव बीन टॅम्प्यून, बिकॉज टॅम्प्यून हॅज अ डिफरंट साईज. बट इन इंडिया टॅम्प्यून्स आर नॉट इझिली ऍक्सेप्टेड, दे आर नॉट केप्ट इन वजायना. बट जनरली टू ऑर थ्री पॅड्स इज एन एव्हरेज थिंग. अ पॅड इज अराउंड 15 to 20 ml बाय विच द वुमन चेंजेस. And if it is there around two pads a day, it doesn't mean that she is bleeding a lot. But if it goes to around 5 pads, average size, non-maternity size pads, non-maternity size, maternity size is a very big kind of a thing when we give it for the postpartum, post-delivery period. And 30 ml is again, because this ml business is relative. And for quantification, we have kept it. For definition, we have kept it as 30 and 80. What is polymenorrhea? Average cycle length is 28 days plus or minus 7 days. So 28 plus 7 is 35. 28 minus 7 is 21. So whichever is less than 21 is poly. It's poly. And whichever is extended beyond 35 is oligo. This is again, I'm impressing on your mind, is oligo is not less bleeding. Generally, oligo is less. Polyhydramnios, oligohydramnios. Oligo is less. But here is the exception. Oligo is prolonged. So you need to ask a question to a woman whenever there is a history that, is it really prolonged beyond 35 days? Nobody is going to calculate exactly. Uttar sangitla jat nahi mahina did mahinyala kadhi tari yete, kadhi pavne don mahine yete. Pan did pavne don mahine zale ki samjhayacha ki nakki oligomenorrhea hai. Nahi khup lavkar yete, ervi agdi month to month aste, 30 divsala yete, pan magcha cycle 24 divsachat zala mi kay karu. Tavela, different kind of assurance has to be given because 24 days cycle can be considered as a normal cycle. So, what is this now? Anybody? Metrorrhagia. Is intermenstrual bleeding. Is intermenstrual bleeding. Metros is menses. So anytime regia is flow. So anytime if there is flow, it is metrorrhagia. So it can be presented as premenstrual spotting. It can be presented as mid-cycle spotting. It can be presented as post-menstrual spotting. It can be continued bleeding for around 10 or more days. One more thing. I'm sorry. I did not tell you about menorrhagia in a different way. Menorrhagia can be, total amount is 80, but menorrhagia can be very heavy menses for a normal 2-4 days. Okay, so it's a big blot on a blotting paper, big blot of ink on a blotting paper, or it can be medium sized ink blots on 4-5 blotting papers. So even if it is normal bleeding per day, but if it is extending for around 7 or 8 days, it is again menorrhagia. Or it is very heavy bleeding lasting only for 2 days, it is also menorrhagia. So menorrhagia therefore was quantified more than this qualitative definition. What is this? Mid-cycle spotting. In German, we always been taught two German terms. It's Mittelschmerz and clean a regal. Mittel is middle, smudge is discharge, or smudge is pain. So it is mid-cycle pain, it is called as Mittel smudge. And clean a regal, regal is red. Clean a is clean. So if there is a clean blood, a small blood, exactly at mid-cycle, which is there only in the form of a spotting which doesn't go beyond 24 hours, is indicative of ovulation. This is ovulation bleeding. Some of the ladies would come to you and say that माहित नाही पण गेले दोन चार सायकल मला एक्झॅक्टली दोन सायकलच्या मध्ये एक दोन स्पॉट जायला लागले. आणि त्यावेळेला इफ शी इज विलिंग फॉर अ फर्टिलिटी, तिला एक वाक्य सांगा, अगं बाई हे खूप छान आहे तुझ्यासाठी, दॅट इज द इंडिकेटर ऑफ ओव्ह्युलेशन, हॅव युअर कॉइटल सायकल प्लस ऑर मायनस टू डेज अँड देर अ हाय चान्स ऑफ कन्सेप्शन विदाउट डुईंग एनिथिंग. प्रॉब्लेम कसा होतो इथे की ते ब्लिडिंग झाल्यावर मेनी ऑफ द वुमेन आर ड्रिव्हन अवे फॉर हॅव्हिंग अ कॉइटल ऍक्टिव्हिटी. बट इफ यू कॅन टेल दॅम दॅट दिस इज पेन, हा सुद्धा तसाच भाग आहे. एक्झॅक्टली नेमकं त्याच वेळेला मिड सायकलला पेन आलं की द कपल रिफ्रेन्स फ्रॉम अ क्वाइटल ऍक्टिव्हिटी अँड दॅट गोज फॉर अ व्हॅल्युएबल डेज ऑफ द फर्टिलिटी सायकल. सो दिस कॅन बी कन्सिडर्ड ॲज नॉर्मल, बट मेनी ऑफ द टाइम्स दिस इज ॲबनॉर्मल, दिस इज ऑल्सो ॲबनॉर्मल. प्री मेन्स्ट्रल स्पॉटिंग अँड पोस्ट मेन्स्ट्रल स्पॉटिंग आर मेनली रिलेटेड टू द ॲबनॉर्मल ऍक्टिव्हिटी ऑफ कॉर्पस ल्यूटियम. So whenever corpus luteum activity is prolonged, then there will be post-menstrual bleeding. Okay? Whenever the corpus luteum activity is abnormal, suddenly there is shrinkage of corpus luteum, support of progesterone and HCG is gone and the endometrial support goes away and she bleeds. So pre-menstrual and post-menstrual bleeding is related to corpus luteum and then to HCG and then to the progesterone. So now, what is polymenorrhagia? What is polymenorrhagia? Polymenorrhagia. It's heavy and frequent. It's combination of poly and meno. It is heavy and also frequent is polymenorrhagia. It is menometrorrhagia. What is menometrorrhagia? It is a combination of menorrhagia plus metrorrhagia. So it is intermenstrual heavy bleeding. We did talk about the spotting, but if it is intermenstrual heavy bleeding, it is called as menometrorrhagia. And this is one classical term where metropathia hemorrhagica is the bleeding which is being followed by period of amenorrhea. So there might be 2 months, 3 months amenorrhea, 4 months amenorrhea, and suddenly she comes, might nahi. These are especially perimenopausal women, and these will always come to you saying that, gele 4 mahine kahi zala nahi, but attacha je suru zala, te atta 15 divas chaluch hai. So this is typical of metropathia hemorrhagica. So these are the things that are to be kept in mind. Therefore, amenorrhea is the term which is not included actually in AUB because amenorrhea is cessation of menses, absence of menses. Therefore, it is called as amenorrhea. But amenorrhea is not abnormal bleeding. It is stoppage of bleeding. But this is the term where amenorrhea has to be included in topic of AUB. So, what is the concept of AUB? Concept of AUB, because you must have in your early medical schools, you must have heard the term of DUB rather than AUB. DUB is dysfunctional uterine bleeding. Then why this AUB term has come? Abnormal uterine bleeding. One thing is very clear. Whatever is coming out of the vagina and if it is there related to uterus, it is there with them. But there can be some organic causes, there can be some functional causes, there can be combination causes. What are the organic causes? Simplest example is fibroid uterus. Whenever there is fibroid there, 90% of the fibroid cases are there with menorrhagia. So that is PV bleeding. Sometimes there is no fibroid, there is no adenomyosis, there is no endometrial hyperplasia, there is nothing. On ultrasound, you get normal size uterus with normal kind of endometrial thickness. Then what is to be done? Then it is the dysfunction of the whole system. That dysfunction of the whole system is HPO axis. I'm not going to go in details of HPO axis, but what is that HPO axis? Is hypothalamo pituitary ovarian axis. So if it is being disturbed, then you are going to get unopposed estrogen. No formation of ovulation. If there is no ovulation, no progesterone. If no progesterone, no corpus luteum. And all, either ovulatory cycles or anovulatory cycles, which will be leading to abnormal menses, and that is functional. So therefore, a lot of thought was given that whether it is always functional or it is organic, but for the patient and but for the treating physician, it's always a problem. How do I go about it? Therefore, this term was introduced in a bigger way, that DUB concept is a subset of AUB. DUB concept is a subset of AUB. So we have taken all DUB dysfunction, that is ovarian dysfunction, ovulatory, non-ovulatory, that has been included, plus some organic causes, and that organic cause may be as severe as carcinoma cervix. Carcinoma cervix that bleeds. It may not be uterine, but it has to be ruled out before it is to be called as AUB. So abnormal uterine, therefore that cervix always is a juncture, whether to include it or not. Because if there is cervical polyp and that polyp is bleeding, it is to be included in AUB, except for this. So therefore, it's a bigger set for our convenience and for easy going for the approach of the treatment. This was the concept of AUB that was formed. Anybody has idea about this concept? Anybody? On your left hand side is palm. On right hand side it is coin. Palm and coin. Okay, what is that? Actually, this is the newer classification. Actually, it is not coin, it is coen. C-O-E-I-N. But to remember it very nicely, it is what is called as palm coen classification. This is a FIGO classification. FIGO classification is Federation of International Obstetrics and Gynecology. This has been standardized practice now, and why it has been useful, look at here. This is palm. Okay? P for polyp. Let it be endometrial, let it be cervical. Cervical can be seen, endometrial may not be seen, but it will be seen on ultrasound. So what is the difference over here? The thing which we were not seeing, initially all endometrial polyps were a diagnosis of exclusion because we used to call it as DUB. Hatala kai lagat nahi, disat nahi, aat kai hai, maiti nahi hai, toh ma DUB manun label kara. आता त्याच्याऐवजी आम्ही काय म्हणतो की एयूबी म्हणून लेबल करा. ओके, अल्ट्रासाऊंड नंतर आत पॉलिप दिसलं तरी ते एयूबी मध्ये फिट होतं, आता ते डीयूबी मध्ये फिट होत नाही. कारण इथे फंक्शनल कॉज मिळाला का? मिळालाच, पण त्याच्याबरोबर ऑर्गॅनिक कॉजही मिळाला, कारण तिथे एक आपल्याला पॉलिप दिसलं. सो दिस इज द वे दिस इव्होल्युशन ऑफ पाम कोएन क्लासिफिकेशन इज देअर. सो इट इज व्हेरी व्हेरी इंटरेस्टिंग ऑल्सो. This is endometrial or cervical adenomyosis. Just tell me, is dysmenorrhea included in DUB? It's painful menses. It is not. This is the term which may be associated with menorrhagia, but this is not the term included in AUB. Dysmenorrhea is painful menses. Leiomyoma is nothing but fibroid. It can be anything. It can be there as submucosal also, because subsera generally are palpated by biomanual examination. But if it is submucosal, sagas endometrial cavity madhe hai, te kai kalat nahi, there is generalized overgrowth of the uterine mass. And again, in those old days, I still call it as zalo ata ab tak 56 zalo. त्याच्यामुळे जेव्हा अब तक 56 होतात मंडळी, तेव्हा मागच्या गोष्टींचा विचार करायला लागतात आणि मागचं सगळंच गोल्ड वाटायला लागतं. बट एनिथिंग ग्लिटर्स दॅट नॉट गोल्ड. बट सिमिलरली दॅट ग्लिटरिंग ऑफ अ इन्क्रीज साईज ऑफ युट्रस इज नॉट गोल्ड नाव, बिकॉज देअर वी वेर थिंकिंग ऑफ डीयूबी. बट वेन यू गेट ॲडिनोमायटिक सिमटम्स, नॉट इवन सिमटम्स, साइन्स अँड सम ऑफ द प्रेडिक्शन्स ऑन अल्ट्रासाऊंड, then we are calculating it as, again, the organic cause, not the functional cause. And therefore, the next is malignancy or hyperplasia. On ultrasound, what is the cutoff for endometrium? 8. The diplomatic answer would have been, it depends on the menstrual cycle on which you do the ultrasound. Okay, हे मी माझ्या नेहमी स्टुडंटना सांगतोय, आपल्यासाठी नाहीये, पण अशी काही काही वेळेला डिप्लोमसी सांगावी की नाही परीक्षेच्या वेळेला याचा विचार करावा, कारण जास्त डिप्लोमॅटिक व्हायला लागलं तर ते आपल्याच अंगाशी येतं. ओके, सो शेवटी आय एम गोइंग टू कॅच यू अप. ओके, ऍज युजल आय एम अ पक्का एक्झामिनर. टेल मी वेन इज इट 8 अँड टेल मी वेन इज इट 10. ओके, राईट. सो पेरी ओव्हुलेटरी, जनरली इट इज बियॉन्ड 1 सेंटीमीटर. पेरी ओव्हुलेटरी इट इज अराउंड 1 to 1.1 सेंटीमीटर अराउंड ओव्हुलेशन. इट नेवर गोज बियॉन्ड 1.4. सो 14 mm इज अ कट ऑफ. 14 mm इज अ कट ऑफ. वेन एव्हर द एंडोमेट्रियल थिकनेस गोज बियॉन्ड 14 mm, 1.4, यू शुड इव्हॅल्युएट ऍज हायपोप्लासिया. Till that time, just ask, when was the ultrasound done? But if it is the ultrasound which has been done immediately after menstrual cycle, and if you get around, say, 6th or 7th day of menstrual cycle, and you get around 10-12, then you cannot repeat it on the 3rd day and thinking that she would be ovulating. But then, your antenna should go up and say that this might be hyperplasia. Not surely my hyperplasia, but this might be hyperplasia. So this is regarding hyperplasia. I'm not going to go in details of hyperplasia. This is also something different, is von Willebrand disease. Von Willebrand disease is a coagulation disorder, and where they have added this P is polyp. There was a polyp at the same time. C is coagulopathy. So therefore it is P1A0L0M0C1O0E0I0IN0. So if you look at this, this is structural. If you look at this slide, this is functional. So what is coagulopathy? Rare, but it can be there. Ovulatory dysfunctions, many of them are non-ovulatory. So whenever there is abnormal bleeding, think it to be estrogen predominance, and they are non-ovulatory. Ovulatory ladies have 2 good things. They have regulatory cycles and they have painful cycles. So whenever there is pain during menstruation, she is ovulating. As simple as that. Okay, atta khup kits sudha alet, peri-ovulatory LH search paise kit alet. It's very simple a test like UPT. प्रेग्नन्सी टेस्ट सारखे त्याच्या ड्रॉप टाकायचा. इफ यू गेट अ एलएच पीक विद इन नेक्स्ट 12 to 24 hours, शी इज गोइंग टू ओव्युलेट. दॅट दीज आर देअर, दीज किट्स आर अवेलेबल. बट जस्ट आस्क अ सिम्पल क्वेश्चन, आर यू हॅव्हिंग रेग्युलर मेन्सेस अँड इज इट पेनिंग? मेनी ऑफ द शाय विमेन विल टेल नो, इट इज नॉट पेनिंग, ऑर इट इज डिपेंडिंग ऑन द थ्रेशोल्ड ऑफ हर ओन पेन. डिसमेनोरिया देअरफॉर हॅज टू बी डिफाइंड एज painful menses beyond tolerance. Every woman, if you ask a direct question, काय दुखतं का पाळी, ती म्हणेल हो. पण दुखतं का आणि त्याला काही गोळी घ्यावी लागते का, मेक्स अ डिफरन्स. इफ इट इज सिम्पल टॅबलेट लाईक मेफ्टाल्स पास, इफ इट इज नीडेड टू बी टेकन, देन इट इज डिसमेनोरिया. दिस इज एंडोमेट्रियल अगेन. Many of the times you do not get anything, you scrap the endometrium, you send it for histopathology, and suddenly you get hyperplasia. So that is been there over here. Iatrogenic. Can anybody give the simple example of why iatrogenic has been included? Copper tea? Yes, you are right. But as the gynec fraternity, copper tea has been dispopular or unpopular because of ourselves. To be very frank, नको ग बाई घालूस, हा त्यांनी तुझे सायकल्स हेवी जातील आणि मग माहीत नाही. बिकॉज वी आर मेनी ऑफ द टाइम्स स्वे अवे द पेशंट्स फ्रॉम बुईंग पुट इन अ कॉपर टी. I can tell you, in 2013, I put in the progesterone-containing IUCDs. There was a lot of convincing that I needed at that time. It was a time given for 5 years. In the last 6 months, I'm getting the patients back, having the follow-up of those 5 years. Initially, they were very... Because, ajun ek samjut asa, I'm sorry, I'm diverting a little bit, but ashi khup samjut asa ki menstruation zala nahi tar weight gain hota, menstruation zala nahi tar progesterone kuthe tari gadbad karta, menstruation zala nahi tar tumche hypothalamus pasna gocha hota, asa kahi hot nahi. The biggest advantage to be seen is they will have hypomenorrheas or they will have amenorrheas. सांगायचं कारण असं की जेव्हा या लेडीज माझ्याकडे आल्या की ज्यांना कन्व्हिन्स करणं खूप अवघड होतं की बाबा तुम्हाला कदाचित पाळी येणार नाही किंवा तुम्हाला इंटरमेन्स्ट्रल स्पॉटिंग होईल. आता इंटरमेन्स्ट्रल स्पॉटिंग झाली की पहिला प्रश्न असतो की मला नवस फेडायचं आहे, ओके, माझी घरभरणी आहे, ओके, माझ्या मुलाचं बारसं आहे. कारण नेमकं त्याच वेळेला पोस्ट डिलिव्हरी मेन्सेस सुरू होतात आणि त्या कधीही सुरू होतात आणि मग मला काहीतरी द्या. आय हॅव गिव्हन यू अ क्लू फॉर द नेक्स्ट कॉज ऑफ आयट्रोजेनिक. काहीतरी द्या. सो समथिंग विच इज बीन गिव्हन फॉर पोस्टपोनमेंट ऑफ प्रीपोनमेंट ऑफ द मेन्सेस बिकम्स अ ग्रेट कॉज ऑफ एयूबी. राईट, बिकॉज यू गिव्ह इट फॉर 2-3 days, इट स्टॉप्स. On her own, she will take 2-3 days more. This is one pattern. Or 3 days she takes. Later on, after 4 days, she starts menstruating or she starts PV bleeding again. She never comes to us. She goes to the shop, takes 6-7 more, bleeding stops, again comes, and later on, फक्त एकदम innocent चेहरा करून येतात. काय झालं मागच्या महिन्यात कळलं नाही. चार पाच दिवस थांबलो पण परत सुरू होत आहे. इफ दॅट इज बीन द आन्सर दॅट इज बीन गिव्हन, फर्स्ट थिंग टू आस्क इज डिड यू कन्झ्युम. डिड यू कन्झ्युम एनी ऑफ द ओरल कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव्ह पिल्स ऑर समथिंग विच आर गोइंग टू पोस्टपोन ऑर प्रीपोन युअर मेन्सेस. क्वाईट कॉमन. आय एम नॉट हर्टिंग एनी विमेन ओव्हर हिअर अराउंड, ओके, बिकॉज दे विल कॅच मोर ऑफ द विमेन प्रॅक्टिशनर्स. And women practitioners inside also support them. याच्यात दोन गोष्टी खूप कामाला येतात. एक सासू, दुसरी आई किंवा तिसरी नणन. मला का माहित नाही बहिणी खूप कमी असतात बरं का, पण या तीन व्यक्ती खूप सारख्या येतात. का पोस्टपोन करायचंय? नाही, सासूनी सांगितलं की ते देवाचं करायचंय म्हणून आम्हाला पोस्टपोन करायची. बट इट इज फ्रॉम युअर इनसाइड दॅट इफ यू आर बॉर्न एज अ लेडी देअर हॅज टू हॅव द मेन्सेस. अँड मेन्सेस इज नॉट समथिंग ऍबनॉर्मल. कुठल्याही देवादोपानी सांगितलं नाही की बाबा आज मेन्सेस आहेत माझी पूजा करू नको. खंडेराय म्हणलं नाही आणि कुठली देवीही म्हणली नाही. पण हे जोपर्यंत आपण त्यांना सांगत नाही तोपर्यंत ते होणार नाही. अँड देन problems of AUB. See, problems of AUB with organic cause can be dealt very easily. Problems of AUB with functional causes are to be dealt in very different way. So, is it being clear? Palm, it is not coin. There is E in between and that E is again dubious, is endometrial and not yet classified. Many of the times you do not get any cause. So that is still to be there. For that concept of DUB has to be there. Go on ruling out any causes. If you do not get any cause which fits in, then call it to be DUB, dysfunctional. Okay? Or, there can be now a lot of things which can be taught on this is thyroid. Okay, is hypothyroidism. Many of the times, it's not hyperthyroidism, it's hypothyroidism. You correct that hypothyroidism and you will get correction of menses. Second one to remember all the time is hyperprolactinemia. Hyperprolactinemia will go for hypomenorrhea or amenorrhea. It will reduce the menses amount. And therefore, these two are the things which are to be kept always in mind. Rest of the hormones, generally, ma apli ek battery tayar hote. म्हणजे ती आमच्यासारख्याच कन्सल्टंटकडनं तर ती खूप होते. सुरू करायचं वरपासनं ते हिमोग्राम, युरिन, व्हीडीआरएल, नंतर मग एफएसएच, एलएच, प्रोलॅक्टिंग, टीएसएच, फ्री टी थ्री, फ्री टी फोर, ओके अँड व्हॉट एव्हर, हा आणि त्याच्याबरोबर चवी चवीला बी ट्वेल्व आणि डी थ्री, ओके हे असं सगळं टाकलं की शांत समाधान, हा पेशंटही खुश आम्हीही खुश. पण प्लीज तसं करू नका. बी ट्वेल्वचा म्हणजे जे म्हणतो ना की एक असा रिमोट संबंध आहे, बी ट्वेल्व मुळे तो पर्निशियस अॅनिमिया होईल आणि मग त्या पर्निशियस अॅनिमियामुळे ते ब्लीडिंग होईल आणि मग ती प्रेझेंट करेल की मला एयुबी आहे आणि आम्ही खुश. बी ट्वेल्व, अगं नॉनव्हेज नाही का खात, जरा खात जा, हा म्हणजे तुझं बी ट्वेल्व नीट होईल. आय एम सॉरी अगेन आय एम डायव्हर्टिंग माय टॉपिक, बट यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू गिव्ह जस्ट अ बॅटरी ऑफ इन्व्हेस्टिगेशन वन्स यू गेट दॅट एयुबी, राईट? सो दिस इज आय वॉन्ट टू टेल अबाउट that this classification but has given a lot of things to us. This has been clarified many concept of us also, and once you tell this to the patient, she says that yeah, I am fitting in this and you can proceed. Now management, I'm sorry, one slide is I think off. Before management is, so how do you diagnose? Diagnosis, again, it's simple. It's history. You will find many of the iatrogenic causes. Then simple examination. Simple examination rightly starts from anemia. Okay, there are so many ladies who will not tell you anything about last six cycles, what has happened, and she will come to you just saying that, mala ata breathlessness hoto hai. So, tyanna ekach udaharan dyaycha ki te phutkya avdacha. किंवा गळक्या तोट्यांचं उदाहरण द्यायचं की बाबा रे महिनाभरात 21 दिवसात जे आरबीसी सायकल असतं आणि ज्यांचं तुमचं हिमोग्लोबिन चांगलं होतं ते उरलेल्या त्या 4 दिवसाच्या मोठ्या तोटीनी ते निघून जातं. सो अॅनिमिया इज टू बी ऑलवेज केप्ट इन माइंड. सो दिस इज आय एम नॉट टेलिंग यू जनरल एक्झामिनेशन, सिस्टमिक एक्झामिनेशन अँड पर स्पेक्युलम पर वजायनम, बट इट हॅज टू बी देअर कॉन्सन्ट्रेटिंग ऑन अॅनिमिया. देन सिम्पल पर अॅबडॉमिनल एक्झामिनेशन to find any of the tumors that have been palpable per abdominally, and then per speculum and per vaginum. This is the standard format. But to impress on your mind is, again, we are not going to jump. I know that ultrasound has done a greatest boom for obstetricians and gynecologists. You before doing anything, you send a patient to the ultrasound and much of the palm coin comes to you to your health. Now, this is very old slide of mine, okay, or mine is there in the book, which I often told, even this is very crude, I understand, because 30% of all ladies in reproductive age group will have AUB sometime in her life. 30%, 30 to 40%. So major chunk of AUB is there in between 20 to 40 years, okay. Rest are two extremes. So therefore, I divide it as less than 20, 20, 40, and more than 40. Less than 20, absolutely, 3 crosses. Okay? I've seen only one patient, intractable bleeding, was not given control, just a 16, 17-year-old. We were thinking, what has happened? Ultimately, we had kept her for radiotherapy. Can you believe this? We were having the endometrial castration with radiotherapy. But ultimately that single patient led to hysterectomy. But this is rare. Therefore, 3 big crosses for hysterectomy. There is a cross for DNC also. She sees less than 20. She may be married. She may not be married. Her hymen may be intact. And if it is the hymen which has been intact, okay, then we should refrain ourselves from doing even the DNC. Any operative is not good for her. We have been. So majorityly, we'll have the management with medical. We'll go to this age 40. Here, DNC is mandatory, practically. If not DNC, it is biopsy with DNC. Because this is a vulnerable age for all carcinomas. There are good fixed antennas in obstetrics and gynecologists. These are to be kept high. One antenna is towards cervical cancer. Second antenna has to be there for ectopic pregnancy. So always whenever the patient comes with pregnancy, very early pregnancy, there has to have your antenna up. Can there be the ectopic pregnancy? If there is bleeding in perimenopausal, first thing that you are going to rule out is can there be cervical cancer? So pose them for pap smear. Pose them for colposcopies. Pose them for DNCs. Rule out all possibilities of carcinoma and then think of the two. What are these two? Then think of medical or think of hysterectomy. But the problem really is there in the reproductive age group, where problem of AUB is more common than these two ages. And what has been there? Hysterectomy, you do not. Hysterectomy will be the choice after failure of medical therapy in this. Baryachya chat 35 te 36 vay asto patient la ek 3-4 mahine AUB asto ani patient mhanta kahi kara majha uterus cha function ata samplay. Uterus cha function mhanje pora paida karna. Ha ata te uterus cha function samplay yala kay arth hai ka? But there, you are there to keep her informed about what are the deleterious effects of the hysterectomy. Even we keep ovaries. The defense to this is do hysterectomy, which is a simple plain hysterectomy, where you keep one or two ovaries inside. So it is not pan hysterectomy. But mind well, keeping one ovary inside is invitation of the great orchestrational organ called ovary, where there are multiple cells which can in future can have carcinoma of any origin. Ovary has superficial cells, ovary has epithelial cells, ovary has germ cells, ovary has gonadal cells. So it is having, and ovary has totipotent cells. So it can develop carcinoma to any extent. So that defense, we are keeping ovary and then there will be no problem with the hormones for at least 3-4 years, even we remove your uterus at 39. But after 39, it's 42. 42, she is going to get what is called as surgical menopause. She will be saved from symptoms of menopause, keeping ovaries inside for around 2-3 years. That's it. So therefore, the first thing is, it's very easy. कि इमारत पाडणं खूप सोपं, बांधणं खूप अवघड. तसंच सर्जरी करून युट्रस काढणं खूप सोपं. टिकवण्यासाठी जे काउन्सिलिंग लागतं त्याच्यात आपला घाम जायला पाहिजे. राईट, सो दॅट इज द थिंग. देअरफॉर ऑलवेज वी हॅव ऑलवेज प्रॉब्लेम विथ दिस एज ग्रुप, हाऊ टू कन्व्हिन्स देम. अँड आय एम ऑफ द फर्म ओपिनियन दॅट अनलेस अँड अंटील यू डिक्लेअर युअर सेल्फ दॅट युअर मेडिसिन थेरपी हॅज फेल्ड ऑर इज नॉट गिव्हिंग एनी एफर्ट, then only go for a surgical thing. So, what is the AUB management? Control bleeding, regulate bleeding, and then surgical approach. Simple. Now, very, very simple things. I can go a little fast also with this. Is NSAIDs. Tell me, rapid fire question. Meftal or Meftalspas? Meftalspas. You take care of dysmenorrhea along with it. But which is real crux is Meftal. Okay, spas is antispasmodic. But Meftal or Meftalspas, anything is there. Second, any other rapid fire question? Anaphoton, Voveron, Naproxen. Okay, anything of your choice would do. Okay, even sometimes you give paracetamol also, because all are NSAIDs. The local factor of prostaglandins is being taken care of. Therefore, all NSAIDs is the first thing. Now, coagulants. Silate, pause. Me ithe muddamun kai commercial name theli ahet barga. Silate or pause. Sharad Pawaran sarka uttar diu naka. Uddhav ka Raj, Thakre Bandhu. Okay, huh? Please tasa diu naka. Huh? Silate or pause. Pause. Why? आम्ही आधीच्या अनेक सीएमई मध्ये पॉज इज द फर्स्ट लाईन ऑफ मॅनेजमेंट असं ऐकलेलं आहे म्हणून पॉज, पण मी शरद पवार आहे. ओके, यूज बोथ. ओके, टू माय एक्सपिरियन्स, दिस इज व्हेरी पर्सनल, आय एम अगेन्स्ट माय आवर ओन स्टँडर्ड्स दॅट आर बीन केप्ट एज फिगो स्टँडर्ड्स ऑफ ऑक्सी स्टँडर्ड्स, एसीओजी स्टँडर्ड्स, आरसीओजी स्टँडर्ड्स. त्यांनी आम्हाला मारून मारून सांगितलं की फक्त पॉज वापरा हा आणि बाकी काही वापरू नका. पण तिथे एक मेडिसिन आहे. एक खरंच इथे माझा कोण स्पॉन्सर नाहीये, कोणी बसला नाहीये, पण ह्या सगळ्या नावांबद्दल क्षमा करा. आयडियली ऍज अ टीचर आय शुड नॉट टेक दीज नेम्स, बट दीज आर व्हेरी, वी आर व्हेरी कम्प्लसंट विथ दिस, देअरफॉर आय एम कीपिंग इट. द कॉम्बिनेशन इज सायलेट टी. देर इज वन टॅबलेट विच इज कॉल्ड एज सायलेट टी अँड देर इज वन टॅबलेट विच इज कॉल्ड एज ट्रॅपिक ई ऑल्सो, अँड यू युअर सेल्फ जज. हा आणि मग आपलं हॉस्पिटल असतं तर थोडस आयव्ही पॉज देऊ, 500 का 1000 द्यायचं, थोडं आयव्ही दिलं की बरं आहे. हा तसंही करू शकता, बट आन्सर इज शरद पवार. ओके, उद्धव म्हणले तर उद्धव, राज म्हणले तर राज. दोघांकडे जाऊन जेवण जेवायचं, ठाकरेंकडे जाऊन गप्प बसायचं. ओके, सो यू कॅन गो फॉर आयदर सायलेंट, यू कॅन गो फॉर ट्रान्समिक, अँड देन यू कॅन डिसाईड. नाव अगेन अ रॅपिड क्वेश्चन फाय. Is Diveri or Primolutin? Okay. If it is Diveri, it is there. Is it there to control bleeding or maintenance? Maintenance. We are talking of controlling bleeding first. There you use norethisterone derivatives. These are better. Okay. Diveri is pure progesterone. Norethisterone is having some aromatic activity. These are technical points. But if you use Primolutin, then these are better. Regestron नावाचं ड्रग आहे, क्रीना एनसीआर नावाचं ड्रग आहे. हे आता सगळे कंट्रोल रिलीज मध्ये आलेत. म्हणजे जे एक फिक्स आपल्या डोक्यात होतं ना, 5 mg 1 TDS फॉलोड बाय 5 mg 1 BD फॉलोड बाय 5 mg 1 HS फॉलोड बाय यू विल गेट समथिंग आफ्टर 3 weeks, या सगळ्या कन्सेप्ट गेल्या. 10 mg कंट्रोल रिलीज विच कॅन बी यूज कंटिन्युअसली फॉर मेंटेनन्स and control of bleeding. So again, I will prefer this to control, but for maintenance this is safer. Why? Because there is no aromatase activity, plain progesterone, and therefore it is there. One costly drug is there which is called as duphaston, dihydrogesterone, which is costly but which is very near to the natural progesterones. Okay, tyachyavar ma sustain vaparaycha ka? Sustain, okay, नॅचरल प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन्स पेक्षा एथिनिल प्रोजेस्ट्रॉन्स वापरा. ओके, देअरफॉर दीज आर मोर. नाव रॅपिड फायर अगेन, चॉईस इन बिटवीन टू, ज्युअलिटॉनेल, डायन 35. ओके, द सब क्वेश्चन, ज्युअलिटॉनेल और मालायन? ओके, नॉट मालायन, एन इज फ्री. ओके, देअरफॉर डोंट कॅच मी ऑन फ्री और कॉस्टली. ओके, ज्युअलिटॉन एन or Maladi, even though it is the cheapest COC available by government, it is painful, it is paid thing. Maladi. Okay, why? Cheap. Then? Okay. See, all COCs, when they are put for this AUB, patient will think, Mala kashala contraceptive deta hai. Okay, therefore a big change, Duolutan L comes in the small pack. Okay, and that will be acting in different mental setup as, yeah, these are the pills for something else. We know that it is COC, but this can be. Just try out this. Dian 35? What is Dian 35? Okay, Dian 35 for all your purpose is to be kept reserved for PCOS. Okay, 3 cycles of, there are different contents of Dian 35, so keep it for PCOS. Then, Depo-Provera, GnRH analogs. On your practice, it's Depo-Provera. GnRH, lot many things to be given. We give Leproid Depo and etc., but it is different. This is one drug which I often use. This is ormeloxifen. The original drug name is ormeloxifen. Sevista is 30 milligrams or a 60 milligram of a drug. Convenient dosage. Initially give 60 milligram twice a week. Twice a week only for 2 months, followed by 60 milligram once a month. Once a week for around next 3-4 cycles, and you will get quite a good control. But again, a word of caution that there may be hypomenorrhea or there may be amenorrhea with this. Okay. Newer drugs, mifepristone. It is antiprogesterone. This is antiprogesterone, but at the same time, sometimes it goes for endometrial hyperplasia. So there have been trials. It's been used as 25. It's been used as 50. And uliprestol is the newest one, but it is very costly. 999 rupees for 10 tablets. And to be given 5 milligrams for over 2 or 3 months, and they are saying that this has become cheaper than what it was. So practically 100 rupees a tablet. But this has the advantages. Some advantages over the mifepristone. But according to me, you stop this and your fibroid grows. So basically these two drugs are there for fibroid. And the other which I have told you, the treatment is treat the thyroid, treat hyperprolactinemia, and treat the anemia. So this is the treatment modality for the AUB. So surgical management. Here conservative, I mean, I'm not removing the uterus. Okay, these are very standard. DNC, hysteroscopy, myomectomy. What is UAE? United Arab Emirates. Okay, this is uterine artery embolization. Okay, here we can have polypectomy also. I think I have forgotten this. Anything which has been there can be taken out. And this is hysterectomy. This is just a revision. It is simple or radical. Okay, radical is along with it, you remove the lymph nodes also. This is abdominal or vaginal, or this is laparoscopic or laparotomy. Anything can be done, but this is a gist. I said that we should be after the medical management. If it fails, you should go for this. So I think thanks a lot for the patient hearing.